Hey guys, in this session we are going to talk about local development. So this is one of the features recently released on 3rd October by Salesforce. This is specifically for Lightning platform and currently only focuses on Lightning web components. So how this helps a developer, or how this helps us. So from now onwards, you can build, run and test your Lightning web components without deploying it to the Salesforce org. So you can just run a Salesforce server or just local server on your desktop or on your system, and you can build, run and test your application right there. And then once your unit test looks good, you're good with your application, then you can push your components to the Salesforce org. So let's jump and see how it works. So this is one of the screenshots of my local server. One thing to note, currently this feature is in beta, but it looks good. I have started using it and it is great. It has reduced my development time. So this is one of my screenshot of my local server of one of my workshop org. So let's see, let's get started and see how it works. So before getting started, you need two things. This is part of SFDX CLI package, but now for now this is in beta and this is not included in the SFDX CLI package. So you need to install this plugin separately. So how you can install it? Just fire this SFDX plugins command install /salesforce/lwc-dev-server. This will install this plugin, and then you have to authorize your org. Once your org is authorized, then you can just fire this command sfdx force lightning lwc start. This will start your local server. So let's go to demo and see how it works. So this is my local server. So once you start a local server, it will look something like this: localhost and the port number 3333. And then it will show you all the packages in your org. And then it will show all the Lightning web components. Currently, Aura components are not supported here. You can only see Lightning web components. So let me jump into one of the component. So let's go to this, my styling component. So you can see, okay, this my component got rendered here, and I can see whatever things it is going to display in my real-time Salesforce org. How this helps me? Okay, so I saw, okay, something is wrong. I want to add some text in this line. So what can I do? I can click on view in VS Code. I can go and open my VS Code. Then I can click on my HTML section. I want to add here, hi Jessica, suppose. Okay, I added this text, saved my file, went back to my local server, saw, okay, text is updated. So see how quick this was. Okay, but hi Jessica is coming in the same line, so I want to separate out the lines. So what, how, again, what I can do is view in VS Code, go here, go to my HTML file. I'll say, suppose I added a comma, then I'll say break line. I saved my file. I went back to my local server. And here I go. The lines are separated. Code looks good. Everything working fine. Again, go to your VS Code and deploy your source to your org. See how quick it was. And you do not need to again and again deploy it to your server, and like it will impact other developers also who are working on that. So once you are good with your component, you can go ahead and test it here in your local server. Looks good, deploy. Then you might be having few questions like how real-time data is coming, or how different modules are attached, because those are on the real-time Salesforce server. So just for your information, my like front end is running on my local server, but this is connected to your org. Like all the data and everything is flowing from your org. So suppose you created a component where you are editing some records, and you display that component here. So if you click on update your record, like you fire an action, so it will go and update your record. So all your apex and your data is referenced from your real-time org. Okay, only the front end is here, so you do not need to deploy that like again and again your front end, make your front end ready here and then deploy it to your Salesforce server. Currently this feature is in beta, so if you have any, like, you can start using it. I have already started using it and it is cool. So you can start using it. If you have any issues, you can report to the Git library for that. I'll give you the URL, so you can go there and report the issues. Like, if you want any enhancement that should be there, you feel okay, that should be there, you want to tell the product team to get it included, so you can post it there. Or if you see any issues, anything which is not working fine, you can just report it there. Okay, so see, I can just come back and see all my components present in my org. So they have given few references also, like VS Code extension and then component library and issues and feedback, and they have given the GitHub repository link where you can submit the issues. This is something cool. Let's go back to our deck. So these are some of the few useful links. So you can go to developer.salesforce.com, tools, VS Code, article, LWC and local dev. So you'll get all the information. So this is just a beta version and this is the first release. So there are a lot of things which are still not included. Like starting a server, you have to fire a CLI command. So they will integrate it to VS. Those things are in their roadmap. But for now, like, you can start using them and see how it works. And they have given all the details on this link. So you can just go and read the complete article. And this is their GitHub link, github.com, force.com, LWC dev server feedbacks, any / issues. So you can just log all the issues here. Thank you. Thanks a lot. If this video was useful, please like, subscribe, share, so that this can help others as well. Thank you. Thanks a lot.